Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. So we have some disappointing news from USA Boxing. They have basically decided that in 2024, males can participate in women's boxing. Males can compete against females. If they're transgender, if they have met certain conditions, then they are allowed to compete in the female category. They are allowed to compete against women who have been women their whole lives. And this move has been slammed all over social media by other female boxers. They're speaking out and saying that this is wrong. And you can imagine other female athletes have spoken out, former athletes, people who are fighting for women's sports, they've spoken out and said that this is a mistake. So let's talk about the certain requirements that apparently make it fair for biological males to compete against women. USA Boxing to allow transgender women to compete against female boxers under certain conditions from 2024 after introducing their new policy. So this is their new transgender policy that will take place in 2024. Apparently, if you are under 18, you must still compete in the category that aligns with your biological sex. They must meet certain criteria, including declaring their new gender identity, completing gender reassignment surgery, and regular hormone testing. Both male and female transgender athletes must have undergone quarterly hormone testing and provided US Boxing with documentation of their hormone levels for a minimum of 4 years following surgery.
While boxers under the age of 18 have to still compete with their birth gender, transgender fighters will be permitted to fight in the category of their choice. They must meet certain criteria, including declaring their new gender identity, completing gender reassignment surgery, and regular hormone testing. So what that means is they will definitely have been through the puberty that they were born with. Well, I suppose unless they had puberty blockers early on. But the point is, you can't change until you're 18. So this is just madness. It's supposed to make it safer and fairer. It does the exact opposite.
Yeah, it's disgusting. You'll still have the upper body strength, all sorts of other advantages. We've seen in Fallon Fox in MMA breaking people's orbital bones and things like that, which does happen in boxing anyway if it's two men, but obviously it's going to make it far more dangerous. You might as well make domestic violence a sport at this point. This is what this is going to be like, just a man beating up on a woman. It's absolutely sick. Hopefully all women will just boycott it if they got, you know, for safety reasons and for solidarity reasons, because which would be hard if they got prize money on the line, but obviously this shouldn't happen. It's disgusting and insane, so I'm on the fence.
There's two arguments against this would be the unfairness, and the people will use this if they want to be violent to women, which is kind of the domestic abuse thing. I think that one is not a valid argument because you have to complete the surgery. I don't think there's anyone who is so intent on being able to hit someone that they are willing to have their bits removed.
No, I completely agree, but it's just about size, isn't it, on average?
Yeah, so that's enough of
a reason. The idea that you're trying to go for health and safety and you let that one slip under the radar, yeah. I mean, are you kidding?
It's a shocking sport as well, isn't it? For that, instead of like darts or motor racing, those are the ones where you could have a good old argument, but hitting, okay, fair enough, I'm not an expert.
Now, I think we need to come to the understanding that it's not just about whether they have an unfair advantage. Males do not belong in women's sports. They're in the wrong category. That's not going to change. So there's a huge emphasis on testing, you know, testosterone. USA Cycling, they are allowing males to compete in women's categories as long as they submit, you know, testosterone levels, they check them. I don't believe it's that frequent, actually. USA Boxing announced the policy on Friday, saying in a statement, "The purpose of the policy is to provide fairness and safety for all boxers." Like, doesn't even make sense. Fairness. You're allowing someone who's male to compete in the women's category. And then safety. Are you kidding me? You're going to let a dude punch the lights out of a woman. The whole point of boxing, you win when you get a knockout. So this person, this male athlete, their aim is going to be to knock that woman out. And they're claiming that they're all about safety. If you cared about safety, you would ensure that people are in the correct categories and that certain categories aren't infringed upon. Why don't they just leave the female category alone? Leave it alone and let them compete against other women. It's dangerous enough fighting other women. But now they're going to be fighting male athletes okay, they've done some Frankenstein-type surgery and they're on hormones. They're still male and they don't belong in women's boxing. And again, what is wrong with them having their own category? What is wrong with that? That's actually the best way to achieve fairness and safety. This is a terrible experiment that is going to go wrong, by the way. And it's only when something catastrophic occurs and people are taken to court over this that, oh, we're gonna backtrack now. So the IOC, the International Olympic Committee, they decided that all sports and different governing bodies, they have their own right to make up their own procedure, basically, to have their own policies in regards to fairness and safety. It's their right to set their own guidelines. So when it comes to USA cycling, USA swimming, boxing, they are left to decide based on what they believe is right when it comes to advantages and fairness. And what I'm noticing is that internationally, they aren't on board with this. When it comes to international swimming, when it comes to international cycling, they're not on board with it. My theory is just because it's on a bigger scale and you're on the world stage and other countries aren't on board with this. Majority of countries outside of the West in particular, they aren't on board with this. And if, you know, the US has a male on their team, I think the Chinese team may have something to say about it. So Boxing's International Federation has yet to determine eligibility for transgender boxers. Obviously, women's boxing isn't as big as men's boxing, let's just be real. But when there's a huge international fight, I don't think people are going to tune in to see a woman fight a male boxer. I don't care how much their testosterone has been tested. I don't care how long they've been transitioning or what surgery they've had. Most people aren't going to want to see that. So this isn't just for males who want to compete in women's sports. It also works the other way around. So there have been female athletes who identify as men who have competed in boxing. So we have, I mean, look at this. Which one is the male athlete? And which one is the female? Patricio Manuel on the left there transitioned in 2013. Although it does say that they competed or tried out for the women's 2012 Olympic team. So it just seems like, you know, they pick and choose what category they want to be in, and they can choose the category of their choice now, according to these new policies. So look, this is a contact sport. It involves aiming to knock somebody out. So I would think safety should be number one. Safety should have been the driving force behind this policy. Now, I'm guessing all of their qualifications, you know, you must have transitioned fully, you must have been on testosterone, we're gonna check your testosterone levels. All of that is them saying that we're making it safe. But we saw in jiu-jitsu, female athletes saying that they could tell the difference when it came to fighting a male athlete immediately. And unfortunately, they weren't even pre-warned. But many of them testified that once they got into the fight, they knew that they were up against something that they had never had to deal with before, which was competing against a male, you know, at that level. Many of them spoke out about being scared, being petrified, being concerned for their safety. So what it comes down to now is if the female athletes are going to play along with this, or are they going to decide that we're not going to compete against biological males? So without female athletes, there is no women's boxing. There is no boxing in that category. And I think they need to make that message clear. So one of three things can happen. No one speaks up and just carries on as normal, goes along with it. Or female athletes speak up and say they're against this, but they still compete. Or they speak up and they refuse to compete. Now, I think the third one is going to be the most effective. Now, if they do compete against males, they're going to tell us the reality of it. Is it the same as competing against another woman? Or is it going to be like the women in the jiu-jitsu who said that they had never experienced anything like that? And it was scary and very disturbing. I think that's going to be the case because this is boxing. You're going to have somebody who is male punching you in the face. They're going to have the advantage where it's going to be easier for them to knock out a woman? Or is their testosterone being at a certain level going to eliminate all of that? I don't think so. But we shall see. This is a terrible experiment that USA Boxing has agreed to enforce upon their athletes. And there are going to be consequences, unfortunately. So USA Boxing, they're saying that they're following the guidance of the International Olympic Committee that says that they're allowed to make their own policies. And a lot of the discussion regarding that decision was based on particular cases, a case in India, and also some studies from Boston's Children's Hospital Sports Medicine and Harvard Medical School Teaching Hospital. Nothing woke about those institutions, I'm sure. The normal range of testosterone for males is defined as no more than 10 nanomoles per liter, and normal range of testosterone for females is less than 3.1 nanomoles per liter. A boxer who transitions from male to female is eligible to compete in the female category under the following conditions. The athlete has declared that her gender identity is female and has completed gender reassignment surgery. The athlete for a minimum of 4 years after surgery has had quarterly hormone testing and presents USA Boxing documentation of hormone levels. The athlete must demonstrate that her total testosterone level in serum has been below 5 nanomoles per liter for at least 48 months prior to her first competition, with the requirement for any longer period to be based on a confidential case-by-case evaluation, considering whether or not 48 months is a sufficient length of time to minimize any advantage in women's competition. Number one, they saying that their testosterone has been reduced to 5 nanomoles per liter isn't going to eliminate the other advantages that they have. But I do have to question whether arguing about advantages is even the way to go. Because they will come up with all this manipulated data that's been sponsored by woke institutions. They'll come up with all this requirements. Well, you know, if it's about advantages, then we'll just make sure their testosterone is at a certain level. As if that's the only difference between male and females is testosterone and estrogen, synthetic hormones. That's what happens when you talk about advantages. But when you simply say that no male athlete belongs in women's sports, belongs in female categories, I don't see how they can argue with that when we have categories in sports for a reason. We are not the same and never will be. Women are not just people with lower testosterone. We don't equal the playing field with a bunch of synthetic hormones. We equal the playing field with sex categories, with weight categories, with age categories, levels of ability, and the need for that doesn't magically disappear because people have been taking synthetic hormones. So boxing star Ebony Bridges slams new policy of allowing transgender women to compete in female category in 2024. This is wrong on so many levels. So she said, "This is wrong on so many levels. I would never agree to this. It's bad enough having trans women breaking records in other sports like track and field, swimming and powerlifting. But it's a bit different to them breaking our skulls in combat sports, where the aim is to hurt you, not just break a record. However, I think it's wrong in all sport. I have nothing against trans, but can't be skewing the line in sport. You don't see reference or debates for trans men in sport. But it's not a threat. It ain't just about the test levels. What about our bone density and a heap of other biological factors? Cutting your bits off and adding boobs won't take back the masculine maturity your body has gone through before you decided you were now a woman." So Bani is an Australian boxer and she believes that this policy is putting women in danger. "I don't care about political correctness. It's politically incorrect to have a man fighting a woman," she posted in another tweet. Very well said. I really hope people support her, other female boxers come together and just refuse to fight against a male athlete. And I don't know, that's exactly what it is. This society is too soft. This is our health and safety. The girls need to stick together, or women's sport in 50 years will be filled with male-born champions. And Riley Gaines said, allowing men to punch women in the name of compassion and inclusivity is incomprehensibly despicable. Two Genders, One Truth said, USA Boxing puts 3,000 female boxers at risk to please males who refuse to compete with other males. The organization requires hormone replacement therapy and sex reassignment surgery, despite neither reducing male advantage. Men using HRT experience minimal declines in physical performance over 12 months, substantially surpassing average female performance for up to 8 years. Males only enjoy a 28 to 40% advantage in combat precision sports and have 162% more punching power than females. Their 60 to 100% advantage in arm length is only reduced by 33% after 3 years of HRT. So the advantages are still going to be evident regardless of these requirements, regardless of the synthetic hormones they're taking or how long they've been taking it for. They're still going to have an unfair advantage. And even without the unfair advantage, they don't belong in women's sports. When a record is broken in a female category, it must be by a female. Otherwise, what worth does that record have? And who's going to come along and break that record other than another biological male? South Park once again has become a reality. We are living in South Park. This is a sport that literally requires punching somebody in the face, in the ribs, and winding them, knocking them out. This is a sport where people have been seriously injured competing against somebody of the same sex. So you can imagine you are increasing their risk of injury. USA Boxing is happy to go along with increasing the risk of injury towards their female athletes. Why can't transgenders create their own sports and compete with each other? Because they don't get to beat up on women. And that's the end of USA Boxing. Yeah, in the women's category, for sure. This person said, USA Boxing will quickly lose value, just like every other sports organization that tried to cancel women. What they're doing doesn't promote fairness. It promotes gender dysphoria. Yes, I'd say boycott USA Boxing, but I don't know anyone who watches it anyways. Oh gosh. Women's sports is not an alternative plan for failed male athletes. Well said. And Riley initially said, USA Boxing to allow men who merely say they are women to fight against women. Mark my words, it will take a woman getting killed before these misogynistic fools wake up. And that's what I'm concerned about. It's going to take something absolutely catastrophic for them to be knocked back into reality. And that's what I don't want. I don't want it to have to take something like that before we stop playing these games. She also said, do you understand what this means? Men will be glorified for beating up on women. Not only glorified, they will be deemed brave for such actions. Slippery, slippery slope. I mean, we're well down the slippery slope. We are far down the slippery slope now. Who would have thought? I remember when there was a debate about women's boxing even existing to begin with. Because it's, you know, not very ladylike. You're punching each other's lights out. I remember that debate to begin with when I was, you know, there's always been debates about boxing. And now we're actually, the main argument against women boxing was that we shouldn't have women fighting each other. We shouldn't have women hurting each other like that. But now they've invited males into the category. So they can be beating on women. So they can be punching them, knocking them out, causing harm, causing injury. All the risks that come along with the sport are bad enough within themselves. But now you have to compete with somebody who naturally has all these attributes that you don't possess. because you're female. Somebody who shouldn't be in that category, you now have to compete against them if you want to continue within the sport, within the USA. Very, very disturbing if you ask me. So let me know what you think. Thanks for watching. Take care of yourselves, and God willing, I will see you in the next video.